Yo, what's going on, guys? It's Kill Luke for the win here, bringing you guys another Road to Town Hall 10 completion. It's going to be episode 2. I'm going to start off with a little bit of defense log. This guy actually had level 4 troops. I think he was a Town Hall 7er, and he just did a pretty good job of using the giant healer strategy, and he actually manages to steal a ton of Dark Elixir from me, and for some reason, these two healers are able to heal these Giants relentlessly. He's pretty lucky that he made it to my Dark Elixir. Of course, he's going to get stopped once he gets there by the Expos. The air defense takes out his healers, and the Teslas do a bunch of damage to his Giants. But anyways, I just want to say a big thanks for... first of all, I did reach 200,000 views, I believe, today. Like, 202,000 views, which is freaking awesome. It's another huge milestone, along with the 2.5K subscriber mark. And, you guys actually left a freaking ridiculous amount of comments on yesterday's video. I was not expecting to get like 100 comments. It just really blew my mind that I got 100, I don't even know, like 105 or something comments on yesterday's video. And y'all smashed like 150 likes. So as promised, I'm going to go ahead and make another video today. I said if I got 100 likes, I'd try to do my best to make another video as soon as possible. And yeah, here it is. The next day, and I'm making a video. So, about the subscriber base review, I want to actually do a little bit of research. I want to actually study you guys' bases a little bit first, the guys that actually did make the cut, and that did comment in time. And yeah, I'm actually pretty busy lately. I'm in the process of moving. I'm just about to move a couple blocks away. You know, my dad's moving away. And I'm definitely not going to go back to my mom's house, so I'm going to be getting my own place with my brother. I probably said this before already, but I have to, you know, you have to go through a process, you have to pay a security deposit and all these things, so I have to do that. So I don't exactly have time to do the subscriber base review, but I'll probably be able to get it out tomorrow or tomorrow the next day. I'm sure it'll be out. But anyways, I want to name off a few of you guys that actually did comment first. So the very first comment on the video, I do believe, if my email is telling me correctly, I have 106 emails just for that one video, like, just in comments, you know, and then I have more emails from subscribers and stuff, but it's freaking insane. Anyways, alright, the first person to comment on that video, his YouTube name is Ben S, his name in-game is, Ben Swearingen. I'm sorry if I don't pronounce these names right. And his clan name is Fully Erect. He said it's the shield with orange and white. I can't believe I'm finally going to get my base reviewed with an excited face. So congrats to him, man. I'm really happy for you that you made the cut, or that you made the top 10 or the first 10 comments. Next we have Chief Keith SA is his YouTube name. His clan is Farmer Geddon, and his in-game name is Chief Keith. Pretty interesting name there, bro. Thanks so much was the last thing he said. Alright, so the next person is going to be Emilio. I think, yeah, Emilio Maldonado. And I think he used to be in my clan or something like that. He's been a really active subscriber for a while. But I think he means his name is NukeBoy173 and his clan name is Leet Sauce. And the Leet is with two threes. So, yeah. Anyways, skipping ahead. The next person, all right, right here I have, this is actually a replay shared by Jay Morrison, my clan. He gets over 1 million in loot in this raid, and this is his biggest raid by far. I think he said the one before is like 800 or 900K, and he did it with Hog Riders like a boss. He was lucky enough to find this guy within that was inactive, a Town Hall, what is this, 9 or 10? Yeah, Town Hall 9er. It was inactive, so of course his Expos weren't loaded and stuff. And even though it doesn't look like he has much Dark Elixir in his actual storage, his collectors or his drills are full, so yeah, he gets a ton of Dark Elixir too, almost 4,000, so I figured I'd go ahead and show it. Alright, anyways, next, the next person to make it, his name is Austin, and his clan name is Symptom Nexus, so congratulations to you, brother. Alright, the next person we have is Johnster with two R's and then EX, so Johnster X, and then his clan is Rainbow Killers. Alright, the next person to comment was the boss Matt, and he just commented, yeah, just, yeah, I don't know what that's about. I'm not sure if you want to be in it. What you could do is private message me, but I'm not sure if you're going to be able to make it because you didn't actually comment your clan name and stuff. Next person was Spada, and he said, yo, great video, man. Thank you. Thank you a ton for your positive feedback. Okay, next. Next person to actually make it, I think it's going to be like number 5 or something. His name is Kakai97, and his clan is Synergy. He's actually a former clan member of mine, on and off. He clan hopped a few times, so I think we stopped letting him in after he left a few times. So, yeah. Anyways, congratulations to you anyways. You are a loyal subscriber, so I gotta give you credit for that. I do appreciate you watching my videos and your comment. Okay, DeBoss Matt commented again, and he said, nice. Thank you. Alright, now he commented, DeBoss, $$45, free man. Okay, so I think that that's going to be, the first one is in-game name, the second is clan name. I will definitely check on that. But if you did, then you freaking commented 3 times before anybody else. So, good job on that, I guess. Okay, so the next one, in-game name, Christam. Like Christian, but Christam. I don't know if he did a typo or what. But Clan Myth. And he said the one with the wave shield. So, shout out to you guys as clans and everything. You guys, if you're looking for a clan, you can check on these clans. Or you can check on my feeder clan. My personal main clan is actually pretty full right now. So, anyways, Spada is going to comment again. And he's going to say, Clan Chapter 1, name Dillawar. So, yeah, you've made the cut. You actually commented twice before anybody else did. So, congratulations to you. But it's your base, so don't bother messing with my base if you don't want to, but it'd be cool. Well, I mean, I offered to, so I'm definitely gonna. Okay, next we have, name is S4MM96. Clan name is Queensland. And I'm a level 113, so awesome, man. I get to review level 100 plus, that's pretty tight. Okay, so I think that's most of them. These people are commenting a ton, so it's kind of hard. I think I'll do one more, and name Gid the Great and clan Raging Beavers 3. So that should be most of them. If you weren't mentioned and you think you were close, then you'll probably be in it, but no promises. I'll get as many as I can. I might even do like the first 12 comments just for the hell of it. Depending on how much time it actually takes to make the video. So anyways, I will be making a series out of this. I want to make a series out of it. I think that you guys gave me so much good feedback and just so much support on that video that you definitely, you definitely deserve for me to have this keep going. So I will probably do another subscriber series maybe in a couple weeks. Maybe I'll do it on a monthly basis. I'm not really too sure. Anyways, on that raid, I got about 500k and over 1,000 Dark Elixir. I was farming a bunch of Dark Elixir, trying to get my queen to level 15 at this point, which was really expensive. And so here, I'm going to show my research lab, and I really don't have much to upgrade, so I'm just going to look around for a second. You know, I can't get the jumps, or I don't really need the jump spells. I never use them, but you know, I thought I could level up my spell, my lightning spell to level 6. I was going to do that, but I can't because you have to be 10 out of 10. And my Dark Elixir troops are way too expensive right now. So I'm just going to go with the level 5 balloons. Even though I never use balloons, maybe one day I'll get them to level 6. And maybe I'll do a level 6, I'll get the minions to level 6 as well. And I could do a level 6 balloon and minion strategy. That would be pretty tight. That's one thing that I will be doing sometime. I know one of you guys asked me to do the golem, all golem strategy with the jump spell. That's going to be really expensive, so I'm going to have to save up some Dark Elixir for that one. But, thanks for, you guys' ideas. I love it whenever I get comments, and I get pretty good ideas from you guys that I can actually use. So, yeah, any feedback is good feedback, whether it be negative or positive. I do appreciate each and every bit of it. So, anyways, we are raiding Michael Andrea right now, and this was like a Town Hall 8er, you know, fairly decent defense. What he was lacking really in this base is his walls. We're a bit too weak. He should have at least level 7 walls at Town Hall 8, you know, or not level 7, maybe level 6 maybe it is level 7. I can't remember, just the light purple ones, you know, not the dark purple ones. I think that's max for that town hall. I'm not too sure. Anyways, we're just going to finish up on this guy. He actually left a bunch of his defenses outside for whatever reason. He's got a cannon out there and an archer tower, a couple cannons. So that's pretty far out of the way. The only reason I'm going to actually destroy them is because he's got these two collectors next to them that have a fairly decent amount of loot in them. So I'm going to go ahead and go for that. As you can see, my level 14 queen is remaining untouched. She really doesn't get hurt that much anymore unless I'm going up against a really strong base. If you place her right, you know, once your troops really get in there, then you drop her. She's probably not going to get hurt or hardly hurt at all for the whole raid. And she's going to do a whole bunch of damage in the meantime. So it's really all about how you use her. Anyways, what I'm going to show here really quickly is just a little bit of me farming some gold. This guy had about 130,000 gold, and I do this every now and then. If I see that all of their loot is right outside of their base, there is no, absolutely no reason for me to break through the walls and three-star the base. I'm only going to drop about 20 archers or something like that, and I got 130,000 gold from that. So anyways, here I'm going to show I get a ton of Dark Elixir for my drills. You know, a bunch of gold as well. Now I have 8 million gold, and I have really absolutely nothing to upgrade it, other than walls. So we're gonna go ahead and get some more walls done, get some more corner pieces. I believe that was the last corner piece for my base. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and get this line of walls right here. Try to get a few of them done. I think that would be 7 of them, since I spent 1 million on the other side. So yeah, we're going to get 7 or 8 walls in total and 7 on this side. And yeah, that was 8 million gold poured in walls. And yes, I actually did just do that. So it is sort of dumbfounding, or you could be dumbfounded by it. I don't even know if dumbfounding is a word. Anyways, I'm just going to add some music to the rest of the gameplay. As requested, when you guys requested, like I said, Logic, Man of the Year. It's a really good song. And I just want to show this raid because that I had almost 1 million in loot. So it's pretty cool to see that this guy was like a Tunnel 7, Tunnel 6, or something like that. Anyways, hope you guys do enjoy the song. Leave a like and a comment. And I'll be talking to you guys later. Peace.
I wonder what it feel like to do that shit in real life. And now I know I got it. That's the reason no ID has signed me on a dotted. But it's still visionary to the death of me. Yeah, I'm trying to make it, but I gotta find a recipe. Greatest of all time, I want the world addressing me. At the hotel, these beautiful girls undressing me. I'm trying to stay focused, I guess that's the Lord testing me. I knew as a child that this was my destiny. They do it for the limelight, but I make sure my rhyme's right. Waiting till the time's right. Smiling at my mom's like, smiling at my mom. Smiling at my mama. Moet, what we sipping now? We was never tripping now. We on private jets, in other words, that means we tripping now. Cause they was over there, I was over here. They was too scared, but I was facing my fears. I've always been driven, but they too scared to steer. That's why I compete with legends. Motherfuck my peers, I'm the man of the year. In the beginning, nowhere to be found when I was down, but you show up when I'm winning. Left me to drown, now I'm swimming. I do it cause I love this shit. Fuck the money and the women, and in the whips with the rims still spinning. I've been at it since the beginning. All these girls screaming Logic, but I wanna hear my real name come from the lips of a beautiful woman. That's real, man. Y'all act like I'm Superman, but I could feel pain. I should've gone crazy, and yet I'm still sane. Love it when they sing to us. Been shining, was bling to us. Yeah, over here, it's only been a year. I was dirt broke, now I'm ballin' like a sphere. I'm the man of the year. let me get my mind right. Cause this is for the fans who truly understand. Real all the time, all A on my fam. Shooting for the stars, a knife in the land. Giving everything I can, why they tell me I'm the man. Making music is the plan. Matter of fact, you could call it plan B. Cause I kill these rappers while they're in their infancy. And I be first to pop off infantry. Gotta keep them in line like symmetry. We all fam, same roots, smoking different tree. And all these people in the crowd sound like a symphony.